Go into the story a little. You got it up in front of you?
There's no real story. That's all it says. There was a burglary alarm. The cops go to investigate. And they pull over a car near the area. Just because, you know, they're suspects because they were near the area. Then he walks up to the car, and there's actual weed plants hanging out the window. Like, the guy put them in the car to transport. And then he rolls up his window, but a piece of it was still outside.
That's too much. Can you say, duh?
Yeah, it's like an ounce hanging out the window.
I don't know. Well, I've seen the picture last night. I'm posting an article. I want you to go. Somebody grab it. It's about Weird Al Yankovic. You see it?
Just came up.
Yeah. Somebody go over that. That one's pretty decent. And then we can get rid of Tiger Woods here. We don't care about Tiger Woods anymore.
I pulled up something else.
I sent it on Facebook. Oh, my God. You hear that cat outside the studio? Yeah. He wants in so bad. He's used to hanging out in here with me. He usually lays right there on the wires.
Well, why don't you let him in?
Because he's a pain in the ass.
Oh.
get ready.
That's awesome. A Weird Al Yankovic Super Bowl halftime show.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought that was pretty cool. Fans petition for Weird Al Yankovic Super Bowl halftime show. That should be pretty interesting. Read into that. Let's hear about that. Joseph Hayden, anyone?
I'm opening it up. I'm going to read into it, so now I'm opening it.
I'm like, hello.
I wasn't just I just read the headline.
Alright. What do you got?
The renewed Weird Al Yankovic fervor that has swept the internet in the past few weeks. One fan has petitioned the NFL to consider him for the Super Bowl halftime show, which will take place in Glendale, Arizona on February 1st.
Nice. You guys listen to any of his stuff?
Earlier stuff. I don't know what he's got out new. He's done one on Happy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Nice. I want to hear that.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
He is weird, though.
Yeah. I'm going to try and bring
but
it up.
But interesting.
But that is his name.
When too. I was a kid, he had that Michael Jackson. He went off on Michael Jackson when I was a kid.
Just eat it.
Eat it. Eat it. Yeah. Yep. What else did he do? I'm bad because I'm fat. I'm fat. You know it. Yeah. Come on.
That's going to be a good show on February 1st.
I think it's going to be pretty funny.
I hope they do it.
Yeah. Where is it? I just had it.
There I wish we could vote somewhere. Why don't we get to vote for this, like in the elections or whatever?
Yeah.
It's always a president.
All right, we're going to bring up a little Weird Al Yankovic here. Let's see if we can't get
the vote for things that matter.
1,000 miles.
Nope, we don't play advertisements for somebody who doesn't pay us for advertisements. So what I'm going to try and do is bring up this...
Lou, what are you doing over there?
I'm not too sure anymore, I'll be honest with you. I've got a bunch of Weird Al shit in front of me, so I want to try and play the one, my favorite... which is called I'm Fat from Weird Al Yankovic. So let's see what we can get going on here. I'm only going to play a few minutes of it, folks. So here we go. This is Weird Al Yankovic. I'm Fat.
Yo, homeboy, where you been, man? We been looking for you.
Yeah, we ain't seen you around Burger World lately. So where you been, huh?
Oh, you know, around.
Want a piece of pizza? Think I got an extra piece around here somewhere.
No, that's okay, thanks.
Yo, ding dong, man. Ding dong. Ding dong, yo.
No, thanks, really.
Yo, eat this, man. It's good for you.
The video's hilarious.
I'm not really very hungry right now.
Hey, man, what it is with you? You on some kind of diet? Is that what they teach you in that little sissy school of yours?
Back off me, man. Back off.
The question is... Are you fat or what?
Leave me alone.
I said, are you fat?
Get off me, man. Stop it.
You ain't down with us no more. You ain't fat. You ain't fat.
You ain't fat. You ain't nothing. You ain't nothing.
Now, if anybody... everybody remembers the commercial. He's now getting fat. He's blowing up and his body's getting fat. It's hilarious.
Your butt is wide. Oh my God.
He's remembered us now, huh?
Or I'll sit on you.
The word is out. Yeah. Better treat me right. Let's see. I'm the king of cellulite. 1988, this song was made. Ham on. Ham on whole wheat. Ham on. Right. Ham and whole wheat.
My zippers bust. My buckles break. I'm too much man.
The best part is watching his video and seeing him on this fat suit. That's the best thing. All right, we're enough with the I'm fat. So what else we got in the news here?
I've got a red tide algae bloom.
We still have this red tide algae bloom going on here, huh?
Well, it's big. It's 80 miles across, 50 miles wide.
Really? Where is it based out of now? I know it was right off the shores of Citrus and Hernando.
That's where it's at.
Is it still out there?
It's like 30 miles off the coast.
Wow. That's crazy.
And it's coming in half a mile a day.
Really?
Or it's heading south a half mile a day. It's going to take out Tampa Bay. It's going to...
No.
Yes? What do you mean no? Read it again. Or read it.
What do you mean no, he says? It's going to hit Tampa Bay. It's going to end up in Tampa Bay.
Yeah.
Tides will end up sucking it in.
I mean, it's not going to take out Tampa Bay.
There's not much living in Tampa Bay anyway.
All the fishing.
Yeah. That's why I was...
There's not much living in Tampa Bay anyway. Well, there is, but yeah.
No, it's full of manta rays and like...
I used to do. I used to spearfish underneath the Sunshine Skyway. That's quite interesting to do.
Right now, they have robots underneath the bloom.
Oh, looking it up at that
because they want to see how deep it is. Because it's not just on the top; like it's a
that's,
mass.
That's our next investment. That's one of our next investments is an ROV, remote operated vehicle for underwater. We have the UAV, which is the unmanned aerial vehicle.
They named this thing the Carenia Brevis.
The Carenia Brevis.
That's how massive this bloom of red algae is.
What?
That just sounds big.
That name.
Right? I'm set.
Yeah, so it's got to be coming from what? Mississippi River?
Who knows? It's bacteria-based. It's all bacteria-based.
I don't know. I'm just wondering, like, how? We didn't have it before. Something's causing it now.
We did. We've had it. It's always been. You never heard of the red tides?
No, I have. But yeah. They're little, and they just splash the shores. This one's like...
Getting worse, just like the rest of the country.
Not to mention we got the vulvaitis or whatever that stuff.
Vulvaitis?
The flesh-eating bacteria.
The vulvaitis.
What did you call it?
I don't remember
vulvaitis. Is that a vagina-eating disease? I have vulvaitis. Yeah. I can't get enough vagina. I like to eat it. I don't know.
Somebody tell me what the real word was.
Vulvaitis. I'm sticking with vulvaitis.
Vibrio.
Yeah.
Oh, Vibrio. Thank you.
Yeah, Vibrio?
Mm-hmm. There's more to it.
Well, Vibrio and Vibrio is two different words. V and B. Vibrio has to do with your vagina again. I think. I don't know. I'm not a doctor, but it sounds good. All right, so somebody call us up and explain to us vagina, non-vagina. You know what I'm saying? We're a little confused here. Well, not that we don't know what a vagina is. We're not that confused, but, you know.
I think you are confused.
Okay. Oh, I got no comment to that one. I was going to say, I'll show you a vagina. I know what one is. And then bring up a picture of a kid that I grew up with. Anyway. After all, you know, he has a big pussy. Oh, my God. So WBAB's, which one of these teachers were arrested for being drunk and pantsless? And which one was fired for having naked selfies that students found and posted online? Well, I got to tell you, they're both horrendously ugly. So I wouldn't want to know either one of them. That's disgusting. Need a tool when hunting Islam pigs.
What?
JB, Florida man allows hunters to use silencers. I love it, JB. When are we going hunting? What else we got here, guys? Come on.
I got something.
Go for it.
They're going to make weed legal here.
We know that, yep.
Yeah, well, they set up five official farms.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But their problem, this is the thing they're talking about today, is how do they get the weed? Because it's illegal federally, so they can't go to like a federal store and buy it.
Right. The seeds, you mean, and stuff to start it?
Right.
Gotcha.
If it's illegal, how do they...
I know where to get them. Just give me a call. I'll have them sent right to your house.
Well, that's what one of the senators was saying. Okay. One says, Senator Representative Katie Edwards, she says we can go through the back door, and there's like a federal farm.
Yeah.
At a university, I think it was Mississippi. Yeah, Mississippi. And then have them ship it to our university educationally as mm-hmm. we're doing tests.
Right.
And then we just steal the seeds from the school. So we're only stealing from ourselves, not federal.
Right, yeah, we're not stealing from the government. Yeah, sure. Yeah.
And then State Representative Matt Gaetz, he said just fill up an unmarked white van and slide it down I-10. Which is pretty much what you were saying, just... Give me a call.
Yeah,
let's get this started already.
I know how to do it. I'll get them here. You want seeds? I'll get you as many as you want. No problem. All straight from Amsterdam. Yeah, it's that simple. I'm going to try and call up Mr. Pauly again, see if we can't wake him up. Call him off the air, though. Guys, take it for a second.
Why are we only allowed 5 farms? I think I'm just confused in the article. I don't know if it's 5. Mic check. Okay. I don't know if this is like 5 federal farms. Is this for like the joints the government rolls up in the pharmacy?
I think they're all personal farms.
Because I think we should just be able to, personally grow. I don't understand why there's 5. Well, like why? They have a map for the regions. I don't know.
It might be just a corner of the market.
Right.
Just like on anything.
They just want to get their foot in the door.
Please leave your message for 7279549.
Pauly, wakey wakey, hands off Snakey. We have a show that we put on at 7 o'clock in the morning, buddy. All right. Where were we, guys? I'm sorry. We were talking about the cannabis seeds and stuff. I'm getting aggravated.
Yeah, you probably should. Just get angry.
No, you don't want me to get crazy. Let's see.
Nevada, over in Las Vegas, they got flash floods. You see the cars?
Oh, yeah, I'm looking at that now. I just pulled that up.
Yeah, it's weird.
Yeah. Got a bunch of things going on over in Las Vegas news here. There was one. This is the clip that I think I wanted to play. Let me just see. No, that's not it. All right, so Las Vegas news. We got some pretty. I don't know what it is, but it seems pretty boring stuff going on. I've been watching. There's nothing going on. We got some dude Frank playing in the back of a Hyundai. All right, so County Commission is give go ahead. To North Strip Arena Project. So they want to build a big arena all the way on the north side of the Strip in Vegas, which they ain't got enough buildings over there. Come on. Police, man shot and back, shooters loose. So that's a good one, guys. For those of you that are living in Las Vegas, we got some news provided to you by Fox 5 KVVU TV. Police, man shot in back, shooter is loose. Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department on Wednesday night investigated a shooting that left a man hospitalized. Metro's Lieutenant Barb Schmidt said officers were called to McKnight Street near the intersection of Northeastern Avenue and Bonanza Road at 9:05 p.m. Upon arrival, police located a man of about 30 years old and... Oh, my God. Pardon me. Oh, I scratched my balls.
Nice.
His condition was not immediately available. The victim was taken to University Medical Center. Schmidt said officers were looking for the shooter, and the victim has been uncooperative with the police. Well, that's your own
fault.
Didn't
he shoot him in the first place?
Yeah, well, he shot the dude in the back. Well, he got shot in the back, but now he doesn't want to tell him who and why, so then obviously it was a drug deal or something gone bad.
Or he just wants to make sure it's taken care of and not left in... the police is in.
Who knows? Here's one that happens a lot here in Florida.